We've predominantly not been using the water to the greatest efficiency as we could have. So yeah, and by, you know, more fertiliser use and using more of the water, and continuing our grass growth, you know, for longer, and utilising our rye for longer. We don't have rye that lasts all year like we do. We have to replant every year. So the more we get out of the cost of putting it in, the more cost beneficial it will be to us. So it sort of inspired me to, you know, go a bit harder. And we've been quite low users of fertiliser in the past. So I will step it up a little bit and put the water on so that we don't have those deficiencies in water as we have been having, and slowing the growth down.
It seems to me you've got a particular interest in energy.
Oh yeah, I've certainly been one of the earlier ones to put in solar panels, and we are looking at expanding the solar system to create a shade system over top of the cow yard, so that the cows will be cooler in the hot summertime, and yeah, and we can use the power, of course. So I think sounds like a good future to me.
How excited or how interested are you in that? There seems to be a fair bit of technology involved in getting this variable rate irrigation, this autonomy going with irrigation systems. How much does that interest you?
Not really greatly, because we use a different system to the centre pivots here, and we would be unable to use the VRO on our system. We have a K-line and bike shift and travelling irrigators, so basically, yeah, we'll... But our system already doesn't do laneways and everything else, so it's a different, you know, it's not a complete system. Ours is K-line, which you only irrigate in the paddocks. You're not using it in the laneways, so we don't have as many issues as they do in centre pivots that go across the laneways and all that sort of thing. So it's not a greatest and a bigger problem for us as it is for pivots. And we can't use pivots. We've planted shade trees for our dairy cows in the paddocks and all that sort of thing, so... And there's power poles all over our property and houses and everything else, so it'd just be too difficult to set up a pivot, I think. Maybe I'll have a look at a aerial shot of the farm when I get home, and who knows. But it's certainly not much labour required for centre pivots, and they've got their good points. That's why I come also, you know, to open my mind up to all sorts of other possibilities. So, yeah, I think it's... It certainly doesn't hurt to have a look at what other people have got and see if you can apply it in your own case.
So you're about to move to Tassie?
No, the wife is certainly not fond of the cooler weather, and I don't particularly like wind, so no, we're quite happy where we are. We have a lot of energy efficiencies, and we do everything efficiently. You know, we breed all our Friesian bull calves and all that sort of stuff, and strip graze all the cattle every day, their daily amount. So we put in the work in those things, creating really good efficiencies, and so we do okay by working hard and doing the work when it needs to be done.
As people say, you know, tractors and four-wheel drives might be standard, but it's hard to have a standard irrigation system.
There's so many soil differences and different requirements for the water usage, of course. We haven't been using our water that wisely, I guess. You know, we tend to wait too long after rain events, and I've certainly learned, that's been drilled into my head this tour, that we do need to start irrigating sooner than what we normally do. They're saying, you know, like the rye goes to sleep and it takes quite a few weeks to wake it up again if you take the water away from the root zone, which is understandable. So I guess we could increase our stocking rate even further if we irrigate it a bit earlier. I don't know how keen the boys will be on doing that when I tell them the news when we get home, but we'll soon find out.